This is the solution to homework three. Homework three was basically build the shell of the blog. This is my local blog running on this local machine. If you recall, I wanted you to make a URL that would list some blog posts. And then I wanted you to make another URL, new post, which allows you to enter a new post. And posts have a subject, which I entered there, and a body that we enter here. And then when we submit this page, we get redirected to a permalink. A permalink is just a link to a specific post. And in this case, it's /2, which is the ID of this blog entry. And then if we were to go back to just blog, we would see all of our blog posts. Actually, not all of our blog posts, the 10 most recent blog posts, sorted with the newest one first. Let me show you the code that I wrote to make this work. So here we are in the main source file. This is the file I've been working from for all of these homeworks. So a lot of this should look familiar. We've got the template loading code here that just basically says I'm going to have a directory called templates, and we're going to put those templates in there. And again, I know we haven't discussed templates specifically in this class because they're not required, but it does make life a little bit easier when you start generating more and more HTML. And I'll walk you through all the templates that I've used. I've got my main handler I call blog handler, and this adds just a few convenience functions. We've seen this before, write and render stir and render. Write just keeps me from having to type self.response.out all the time. Render stir takes a template name and some dictionary, basically, of parameters, things to substitute into the template. And render calls write and render stir to print out a template. Here's homework one solution. Now, we get down to the actual solution here. So, a couple things I've had to do. This function, we didn't talk about this in the lecture, this is for the data store. Basically, when you store things in Google's data store, they need to have some sort of, well, they don't have to have a parent, but for organizing the data, I found it's convenient to have a parent. This basically defines, this is the blog key, this is going to be the value of the blog's parent. The parent is normally another element, but in our case, we just give it a key for an element that doesn't even exist. And I've kind of set the stage here for having multiple blogs, even though we're not going to do that in this course. So it takes a name parameter, but by default, the name just equals default. Here we get to something that you probably have to do, which is define the actual post entry, or define the post class. Basically, all this is a list of the properties that a blog has, or a blog entry has. So it has a subject, which is a string property. It's required. It has content, which is a text property, which is required. Remember, the difference between a string property and a text property is a string property has to be less than 500 characters, and text property can be greater than 500 characters. Also, a string property can be indexed, while a text property cannot. So in theory, I could have used text property for both of these. I tried to stick to what was most appropriate, which would be string for the subject and text for the body. Text also can have new lines in it, which obviously you want in a blog entry. And then we've got two timestamps. First one is a date time property of when the blog entry was created. And this parameter auto now add basically says automatically make this property the current time when you create an object. So we don't have to set it, which is really convenient. And even more convenient is this auto now function. And what this does is every time we update the object, it sets this property, last modified, to be the time that we just updated an entry. If we were listing our blog and we want to sort by creation time, but also display when the last time they were updated, this property would let us do that, and with this auto now parameter equal true, the Google Data Store will keep that property up to date, which is pretty handy. Now, I've added a function on the post object called render, which will basically render that blog entry. One thing it does is we're going to be rendering this in HTML, but the user doesn't type in HTML for the most part. We want them to just be able to type in text with new lines in the text field, but we want to render it with a bunch of new lines. So what this does is this replaces new lines in the input text into HTML line breaks. If we didn't do this, actually, I'll go ahead and show you what it looks like if we don't do this. So I'm just going to comment out the rest of this line where we replace new lines with line breaks, and then we'll see how this works in the browser. Okay, so I've entered a basic blog entry, a little subject, and some contents with multiple lines in it. I'm going to go ahead and submit this blog entry, and you can see that it brought us to this page. We see my subject, and we see my body, and the contents of the blog entry are all in one line. And remember, this is because HTML takes all white space, spaces and new lines and tabs, and merges them into one space. So that's all we get is one space. If we were to look at the source for this file, we'll see that the contents are actually rendered with multiple lines, just like I typed them in the HTML. But when the browser renders that HTML, we just get the one line. So the way we fix that is we replace all those new lines with line breaks. So let's go ahead and give this a whirl again with this string replacement on. I'll reload the page, and we see our new lines appear as we intended. And if we look at the source, we can see that we've entered or replaced our new lines with line breaks. Or that's what caused our blogs to display nicely. Now, we could require the user to enter in actual line breaks as they're typing the blog entry, but that's a little tedious. Although I still want them to be able to put other HTML in. Blogs have links and that sort of thing. So, this just makes it slightly easier. You didn't have to do this. I just wanted to show you how all that works.